ears. Tune in daily, don't miss a single show. Sign up for the newsletter, let us help you grow. Taking risks, making moves, seeking success. Together we'll conquer, no room for any less. Listen now. Good morning, it is Thursday, December 3rd. Tuesday, December 3rd. I don't know what the hell I'm thinking. I am about to announce the winner of the Trendspider giveaway. Okay, the winner of the Trendspider giveaway. We actually did, just so everybody's aware, we picked one winner, and that particular winner only trades on their phone. So thank you to the winner. I won't announce who they were, but they only trade on their phone. And they were super nice and gracious enough to say, because the Trendspider phone app is a glorified, you can't do strategies in the phone app. And that's what I think I sell mostly, is the 4-hour algorithm and other strategies in there. So they were gracious enough to say, hey, can I do it? But I said, no, you can't. I gave them a year of the newsletter for free. So I think it's a decent enough trade-off. They didn't want to get a PC. They didn't want to get a computer. So, hey, trade on your phone. Do what you need to do. If it's working for you, great. Again, find your own strategy. If trading on your phone has worked for you and you can do trades on your phone, perfect. Fantastic. But I agree. My point is, I think that was a gracious, gracious thing. So somebody else won. And the second part of the giveaway, it was Sean Cox. So Sean, you have to notify me. I emailed you. I let you know. See, he retweeted that. So you won one free year of Trendspider Advanced. Hopefully you get this message. So it looks like you didn't get the message last night, but Sean, congratulations. Just email me your email address. I will forward that over to Trendspider, and we'll get you that one free year, and it comes with Advanced, so it's free, unlimited one-on-one training. Again, Trendspider extended their Cyber Monday deal for another day, so you've got about 16 hours left on this. Remember, Enhanced is the one that you want. This is saving 50% per year. You're saving 50% off this one. Off of Standard, you're only saving 15%. It's $4 more. Get the Enhanced. Why? It comes with a free one-on-one training session, and it comes with more active windows, more simultaneous alerts, more trading bots. So you get all of that, plus you get a free year of Signal Stack, a free year of Signal Stacks, which allows you to trade in your brokerage. I personally don't use Signal Stack, but when I asked Trendspider, hey, should I really promote this stuff? They said, absolutely. We all use it. The entire Trendspider staff uses Signal Stack. They trade on bots. What's that? Well, it's when the 4-hour algorithm tells you to buy, you go in and buy. The bot buys it for you. You don't have to think about it. So it's automatic trading. I don't trust that stuff, but it is what it is. I typically like to make the decisions myself as to when to buy. If it's within your budget, you can save up to 65% on the Advanced. The Advanced is a little bit more expensive. But the benefit of this one comes with unlimited one-on-one training. So think about it this way. For about, what, $19 more per year, $20 more per year, somewhere in that neighborhood, per month, you get free one-on-one. So say you want to take a training course once per week. That's about $4 per training course for the year. That, again, unlimited one-on-one training. So if it's within your budget, pay that for Advanced. And then maybe if you don't use it as much, or you don't want the one-on-one stuff, then next year you can always downgrade. But for I think with the savings that you're getting on this Cyber Monday deal, I think it's, for me, the Advanced would be where I would go. Because it took me, they didn't have this offer available. They didn't have one-on-one training. I had to learn it myself. Understand that technical trading, I say it a lot, it's like golf. And for the 100 of people that signed up over the last couple of weeks for Trendspider, email me. Email me your confirmation. Okay, where do you get my email? Where do you get all these links? It's on Linktree, linktr.ee/dailystockpick. It is right here. My email address is in the upper right. Email me your confirmation page of what you ordered with Trendspider. I'll make sure you're on my affiliate program, which gets you the updates on all the watch lists, and I will make sure you get the links for the 4-hour algorithm, 65-minute algorithm, everything that I use, all the watch lists, all the scanners, everything that I use in Trendspider. It is like getting a step stool for a short person in the kitchen. It gives you that leg up. So all you short people who signed up for Trendspider, email me. Where are we in the markets? We're in a pretty good place. I mean, honestly, RSI a little bit extended on the Qs at 65. We're above the 9-day, so you have confirmation. The Bollinger Band's just cinched up and they're starting to expand. You're down 0.21. You know, the time between, there's a thing called a Santa Claus rally. And the reason is because a lot of people try and rebalance their portfolio. In a really good year, you might see a lot of selling because a lot of people might be taking profit. But I think the outlook for next year is positive. So I think a lot of people are starting to buy. You're going to see fluctuations. We're at 514 on the Qs. The algorithm got you in at 508. But boy, don't these back here at 446, at 460, just like a couple of months ago, don't those seem like great buys? The support is probably going to be this previous high in July, and that was at 503, okay? It's not going to be exact, but that's a good support level. If you get under that, I would start adding to it because, again, I think we're in a bull market. This 450 really comes from the weekly. When you take a look at that previous buy in that previous high in March where we pulled back from, and then without the August 5th, which was the Japan unwind trade, that 450 really provided some support there on the weekly chart. Now, the weekly chart, we're a bit extended. The RSI is at 63. It's not crazy. But again, I think we're in a bull market, and we're in a bull market until we're not. Now, I want to talk about yesterday's alpha pick. I won't bring it up, but yesterday was an alpha pick day. And I screenshot I'll put the screenshot of this in the newsletter. The newsletter is free. But the summary of this pick, I had no idea this business even existed. And that's why I'm an affiliate of alpha picks. That's why I put so much money into alpha picks. Summary. It's powering the digital banking for more than 50% of America's top 100 banks. This fintech leader commands significant market share. The company's EBITDA margin has expanded 19% while maintaining 13% revenue growth, achieving coveted Rule of 30 profitability target. Go and Google Rule of 30. That's a very good thing. While ARR growing 15% year over year and a record backlog exceeding $2 billion, this company is positioned to continue its exceptional growth trajectory. Free cash flow has increased to $70 million year to date, showcasing dramatically improving operational efficiency. The total return of the Alpha Picks portfolio continues to outperform the S&P, plus 184% versus 60%, with 8 Alpha Picks soaring more than 100% since their addition. This is a portfolio that is unmatched, absolutely unmatched, okay? This is Alpha Picks. You get one pick on the first. Yesterday was the second. It was a Monday. The first was a Sunday, so they did it on the second. You get one pick on the first and one pick on the 15th. The key to this portfolio is that you get an alert when to sell. It's a rules-based portfolio, and it has outperformed the S&P. If I can steer you towards this, I would guide you towards the bundle because getting premium and alpha picks together at this $289 discount is the phenomenal deal of the year. And again, it's a Black Friday sale that they just extended to end sometime this week, I believe. They don't tell me when it's going to end. You go to Linktree. The bundle is the second link. Okay, if you want just alpha picks, you want just this portfolio. And I tried alpha picks. I tried picking the stocks that I liked. A good example was Sprouts Farmers Market. This is a stock that they picked, I think, back in March sometime. And I said, you know, I shop at Sprouts Farmers Market. Do I think that I really want the stock? I said, no, I'm a big large cap tech investor. Well, the stock was trading somewhere in the neighborhood of 64. You know, I was fine for, you know, a couple of weeks here. This is on the 4-hour chart. The algorithm said to get back in. It said to, you know, to buy it a couple of times here. I didn't listen to the algorithm. Okay. This one right here at 64, you have doubled your money. It's trading at 153. That is an alpha pick. That is in the core, their alpha picks portfolio. It is a phenomenal, phenomenal portfolio. Again, I would steer you towards that. If you want to see, I took $50,000 of my own money and I took, I think, 70 or 80,000 of my parents' money and I put it into the Alpha Picks portfolio like I think a month ago and it's up like 15-20% somewhere in that neighborhood. So it's really doing well. And if you want to see that, I'll include that in the newsletter. The newsletter is on Linktree as well if you don't have it. It's down here. Daily Stock Pick newsletter, right here. I do a free newsletter every day. So if you have any questions, you can certainly just email me back. But it includes all the notes for this for the podcast. Now, let's talk about SMCI. Because SMCI, I got out, I think, at about $26, $27. And I said, you know what, with that, with Ernst & Young backing out and them not having audited results, I'm going to get out of this one. Well, today it's trading at 43. So is that a good, like, does that mean that everything's out of the woods? No. Supermicro yesterday jumped, I think, 20%. On internal review, finds no misconduct. They're just going to replace the CFO. So, one of my friends on Substack, Herb Greenberg, he said, you can't make this up. After a super fast review, Supermicro's special committee finds the company did nothing wrong, as former auditors Ernst & Young had suggested. So Ernst & Young, if you remember, they said, we're quitting because we don't agree. We can't audit these guys. There's so much freaking corruption here. We're not going to audit them. So who is the special committee? The special committee is comprised of Susan Giordano, an independent member of Supermicro's board. She is an experienced attorney, joined the board in August 2024, specifically to lead the committee's efforts to review the matters outlined above, independent from any existing directors. It's one person. One person who's on the board of directors. One person. Read all about it in this Herb Greenberg. He goes over it. How, this person's chief legal officer at Lime, super board member at Supermicro. It makes no sense. BDO hasn't come out. BDO is expected to come out with some type of agreement with this. But this doesn't make me feel more comfortable. Now, we can look at the chart of this one, and it hasn't changed in the quant. But the chart, you can clearly see that this was the support line, and it's now broken through it. So where are you going? I don't know. But last time when we saw this, that green line, that might be the next resistance up there at 72. I mean, just people like this one. I don't want to touch it. That's me. You, like I say all the time, you do you, boo. I mean, that's going to be a you thing. I'm not saying that I'm hoping for it to go down. I hope that everybody in this one makes a tremendous amount of money. But for my risk tolerance, I don't trust one freaking person who says, hey, it's all fine. And she's on the board of directors. It makes no sense to me. But again, if you want to trade this one, absolutely go in and trade it. So I just thought it was important to kind of point out, hey, even though there's good news out there, I don't think when you dig into the details, it's very good news. And if we want to look at SMCI, the valuation makes sense. The valuation is fantastic. And the growth, fantastic. Their profitability sucks. Their gross profit margins have gone from like 18, 19% to 14%. Their momentum is horrible. Their revisions, everybody's revising them down. So again, I don't want to say that this is a crazy, crazy, bad investment because I don't know where it's going. But I don't trust one person. And remember, it got pulled out of the Alpha Picks portfolio the second that auditor came out and said, hey, we're resigning because we don't agree with these folks. So trade it to all your heart's contention. I got a bunch of questions yesterday. I am not getting back into SMCI until an auditor finds out. And they can, if BDO comes out and says everything's fine, maybe I'll get back in. But I'm not worried about it right now. I have Dell and I have NVIDIA. And I think those are two perfectly fine stocks in the AI space that I can play with. Biggest stock movers of the day. Credo. And we'll go over Credo a little bit. Soared after delivering strong 32%. Okay, Sunstone Hotel Investors soared 9%. Supermicro climbed 4% on that. One that I want to bring up is Zscaler. And I think I'd do it in the, well, we'll go over Zscaler in a little bit. Yeah, I do have Zscaler down there. But Zscaler was, I said it yesterday, I thought the Palo Alto and the CrowdStrike were both companies beat and guided higher. They were different, you know, different beats and guides higher. But Zscaler is kind of in the same thing. I own Palo Alto and I owned CrowdStrike as well. I didn't want to get into Zscaler because of the response to those earnings. And I also said, hey, Zscaler is a little bit expensive. And I'm not here to say, oh my God, I told you so. It's just, you can kind of tell from the previous reaction where it gapped down. I would say as this one comes down and it's a 195, I think it's a buy the dip situation. I really do. I mean, nobody's getting rid of their cybersecurity. And as you trade under that 200 day, which is right about 197, and you're trading at 195, I think you come up to it. So it is expensive. It does pop to, you know, here back in February, it popped all the way up to 250. So, but Zscaler, in my mind, I would trade it, but I wouldn't own it. I own Palo Alto and I own CrowdStrike because I think those are the two leaders. The quant has this as a hold. The valuation, again, it's the valuation and it's the revisions. And the valuation, the PE going forward, you're paying 72 times forward earnings. And they're bringing their estimates down. You're paying 61 times forward earnings for the actual industry leader, which is Palo Alto Networks. And if you go for the biggest grower, you're paying 92 times forward earnings. So you can compare those three. I've picked my winners in this one. I own that one. We can go over another one that we'll go over right now is TransMedic. TransMedic shares plunged 9% after narrowing full year 2024 guidance to 428 to 432, which it was 425 to 445. So they've narrowed the margin down. So you're in a high flying stock, you're going to get some type of reaction. And it's going to, you know, falls 10% as it narrows its guidance. We can look at this one. It's a strong sell in the quant. This is one of Shai Bhullar's favorites. Okay, it's his year end kind of, you know, 2025. This is one of his big ones. He has been more right than wrong. He is very much like Tom Lee. But you can see the fall from grace that this one has had, where in its 52 week, it's from 177 to 68. Now you're trading at 85 right now. And it's still a strong sell in the quant. Why? It's the valuation. And the price going forward is 87 times. Mind you, in Shai's growth portfolio, that doesn't make a difference. He's had Palantir. He's had Tesla. All of those in his growth portfolio, they trade at high PE ratios. So you go down and you look at the PEG ratio. They're not providing growth going forward. So let's look at the growth going backwards. It's 109% revenue year over year. So they get a C+ on the growth. And the reason is because they're spending a lot of money. The working capital, they're just losing to 11%. The average loss in this one. This is an organ donation company. I don't exactly know what they do, but I trust Shai that he likes it. Their profitability is a B+. They're making 59% profit margin. You look at their levered key free cash flow, though, and it's losing 39%. So I think this one, you know, if we go to Wall Street and we say, okay, what's the average Wall Street price target? It's 123, but you can see that they're chasing this down. For me, this one would be, let's see, TransMedics. TMDX is the symbol. For me, I would try and trade this one on some type of strategy that works. Now, the four-hour algorithm makes you 3%. You can say that's great. At least I make 3%. But buying and holding over the past 2 years, you're up 47%. The 50-day, moving lower. The 200-day, moving lower. I think this is a buy-the-dip situation, but I think you want to trade this one on the weekly. And I think as you start to approach this 200-day at 62, I think that's where you start adding to this. If you look at these, to get technical in here, if you look at the previous highs where you went, that $99 right there, that's providing some resistance right there. So I think if you buy here at 85, you're trading at 77. So if you buy at 77, I think your upside is 99. Until you can break through that, I think that's 99. But I think your downside on this one, I think you could take this particular one. You can see right there where it hit. I think $50 might be in the books on this one. Again, if they're taking their guidance down, you might see it come down to 50. So I would do a little bit more research into this one, but I trust Shai on this. I think he's got a good nose to the grindstone on that actual company. I'm sure he's going to put out some type of guidance on that. Now, Zscaler drops, but despite solid Q1 results and soft forecast, this is a different story. This is why I say you can probably buy the dip on this one. I don't think any of these cybersecurity companies had bad quarters. And I think you're going to see similar stuff to the last time, where it just is a buy the dip situation. Nobody's getting rid of theirs. Choose your winners. Zscaler isn't one of mine. It's Palo Alto Networks' CrowdStrike. But you could certainly trade Zscaler and be perfectly fine, I think. Again, now, we're going to go to Tesla because this is total bullshit. And sorry for my language, but this is total bullshit. This amazes me. So if you remember, there was a shareholder in New Jersey. I think he had one share, and he was the class action lawsuit for the pay package that was given to Elon Musk, which is a record pay package. And it was given to Elon Musk when Tesla wasn't making money, when they didn't really have the Model 3. They had just promised it. And Elon was sleeping on the floor of the factory. They only had one factory. And it was this moonshot. If the stock gets to a certain price, if the company gets to a certain market cap, then we're going to reward Elon with, I think it comes out to like 10% of the company or something like that. It was a total moonshot. Nobody in the financial world believed that he would ever do this. He did it. He did it. And then this douchebag law firm finds one person that says, hey, the board of directors is in Elon's pocket and it shouldn't be allowed. The pay package shouldn't be allowed. And I believe that this is the case. So the judge says, oh, you know what? We're not going to allow that. So what does Elon do? Elon holds a shareholder vote. And he says, hey, should I get this pay package? Overwhelmingly, yes. Overwhelmingly, the shareholders vote yes. And what does the douchebag judge say? The douchebag judge says, we're not going to allow the shareholder vote. We think that was manipulated. It's shareholders, douchebags. Shareholders. So you got Tesla down to 350 in the pre-market. Is it buy the dip? I don't know. I mean, you know, again, I own a Tesla through XLY. What are the next steps? Dan Ives put it out here. It's not a surprise. The Delaware judge is very partisan. I think they were placed there by Biden. We know the politics that go on with Elon. Whether you agree with it or not, there is absolutely a political discussion with Elon that goes on. And you know, GM is not leading the electric. Let's just say, you know, GM is not leading the electric revolution. They have pushed Elon so far out of the Democratic Party. And I heard Rokhan this morning, who's a senator from California, talk about the bill that is so politically motivated in California, where it excludes Tesla from the state and send EV incentives. What do, you know, Gavin Newsom, douchebag, you're continuing to push this guy out of the stay out of politics, whatever. I don't blame Elon for being Elon. I don't agree with Elon on a lot of things. But I don't blame Elon for hating the Democrats, because I think, you know, there's a reason. But Delaware court rejected it. We expect the Musk $56 billion pay package now goes to appeal courts in Delaware and eventually go to the federal appeals process. Depending on next steps, this continues to be a soap opera playing out in Delaware. You've got this hanging over the stock. And you've got this hanging over the stock in a fairly big way. Because if Elon decides, hey, you know what? It's not worth it for me. I've made my way into politics. I've got Trump on my side. This Department of, I have SpaceX. I may step down from Tesla. I mean, he could screw the entire Tesla universe. I don't think he'd ever do that. But I do think that Elon probably could do something to screw over all of the Tesla shareholders. And again, the shareholders are who's holding this up. Now, I do think Tesla is stronger than this. So I think in any opportunity, if you believe in Tesla, I think you could absolutely buy the dip in Tesla. Because I do think that we're going to these all-time highs back again at 414. Remember how crazy it was when I said Netflix was going to go from 300 to 700? Remember how crazy it was when I said Amazon is going to go from 100 to 200 because that's where the previous all-time high was? Remember how it was crazy that I said Apple was going to trade from 150 back to 180 and 200? All-time highs have a reason to going back to all-time highs. It's just that it's in the stock. And it doesn't matter the valuation, doesn't matter anything. So if you want to buy this stock, you know, Tesla at 350, I don't think you're doing anything wrong. Your time frame just has to be in the right place. Yes, it's expensive. I don't have version 13 for the FSD yet, but everything that I see online is it's really amazing. But I think this is just bullshit. Honestly, I think they need to get over it. It is what it is, but I hope he gets the pay package because I really do. Now, Amazon. We talk about Amazon having that $200 kind of cap there. I think that's turned into resistance. Support. 200 has now been support. I don't think we've pulled really back to it yet, but I think this, you see those green, the red line and the green line? I think that's the range that we trade in going. And I think you'll see some pops on some news. And it's written from a weekly where I just did, hey, where's the support level here? And we pushed that back. We broke through it. We now have another support level. So that old support level, it's going to turn to resistance, but it creates this nice little channel wedge that I think on a weekly chart you can probably trade on. And I think 200 is our new support. I think we're over that 180. I think we pulled back enough that 200 is the support. So for long term, you buy at 210. I think Amazon is setting themselves up to be an NVIDIA competitor with their own chips, their own data center stuff. They're going to build their own data centers. And I don't put it past Amazon to actually do that. AWS said a more efficient cooling system can reduce mechanical energy consumption by 46% without increasing water usage on a per megawatt basis. And so this entire article shows you how Amazon took Comcast to the cloud, how they took Lotus Technology, migrated to AWS. This is a really, really good position because, again, the hyperscalers have said, we're going to spend money to actually make AI more efficient. And so, again, you want money into these hyperscalers because I don't think you can pick the winner. So Amazon, Microsoft, Google, Meta, I think all of those should be in your portfolio. So, earnings this week. We've got some interesting ones. You got Salesforce. These are the week's earnings lineup with the expected one-day move. So, options play. This is from My Weekly Stock Pick, who I really like. If you want to follow him on Substack, he was the reason I got a newsletter, to be honest with you. So, I think you should follow him. It's Substack.com. It's My Weekly Stock. Substack.com. That's how you follow him. But he does a great job with options plays here. CRM plus 7%. Synopsis plus or minus 8%. Aflac plus or minus 2%. You can take Lululemon plus or minus 9% expected. Dollar General is an interesting one with plus or minus 13%. So we can look at the Dollar General chart. It's a shit show. But they've got earnings coming up tomorrow after the bell. I think it's tomorrow after the bell or before the bell. I'm not quite sure. But look at this weekly chart. I mean, plus or minus 9%. If I had to put my money on it, I'd say it's minus 9%. I mean, that's just the way the trend is going. But if you've got, you know, an upward trend, then maybe you've got, if you've got this downward trend, maybe you can make 10% just off the earnings. But I always find this interesting because I don't understand the options market. So when somebody presents that, I kind of look at it. Now, you want to know who's buying any Bitcoin that's actually for sale? It's MicroStrategy. They bought $1.5 billion of Bitcoin from, you know, Thanksgiving to December 1st. $1.5 billion. And they're executing their plan of buying a ton of Bitcoin. Now, MicroStrategy is down in pre-market to 367. We can look at the chart. It hasn't given me another buy. Remember, I sold out of my entire position in MicroStrategy and MSTX. I sold out of the entire position. And the reason was it was the Wednesday before Thanksgiving, and I just wanted to sleep at night. I didn't want to lose sleep over this position because unlike Bitcoin, which is 24/7, you can't trade MicroStrategy when the market's closed. And you're at 362, 363, right as the market opens. It's 931 right now. You're on the underside of the 9-day, which means you don't have confirmation. Your MACD is going down towards the oscillator. Your RSI is at 47. This is in the 4-hour algorithm. It still has you in. It had you buy in here at 125. I wrote my weekend newsletter. Part of the reason why I bought it, I tried to front load the algorithm. Now, it went all the way up. I sold at 380. It went up to 412. So I didn't time it right, but I took 148% profit on this. And I took a profit on MSTX as well. I will get back in. I absolutely will get back in. Because you know who's buying all of this? It's MicroStrategy. They're buying all the Bitcoin. And you know who's going to be the next buyer? It's going to be the U.S. government. And you know who's going to be the other buyer? Microsoft. You know who's going to be the other buyer? Rumble. Because some of these big corporations are starting to actually put their cash into Bitcoin. Michael Saylor's strategy of getting the cash that he creates and leveraging it, not everybody's going to do that. But other corporations will start to buy Bitcoin as part of their cash reserves. And it's just because it makes sense. So, one that I saw was interesting. CTNT, Cheetah, Net Supply Chain. They're acquiring TW and EW. This was up 320%. So let me show you CTNT. Now, when you get this news in the morning, you can absolutely trade something like this on a very short time frame. So we're going to look at after hours and we're going to look at 5 minutes on this, okay? We're getting out of the algorithm and we're going to say, okay, well, where could I have traded this? Well, at 4:20 this morning, it opened up for trading. So you can use Webull, you can use Fidelity. I think Fidelity allows you to start trading at 6, but I think Webull allows you to start trading at 4 a.m. There are others, but I wouldn't put a lot of money into this. But if you bought this and just look at that 9-day, and this is part of what I teach in the Daily Stock Pick newsletter. If you go down here to the education section and you see all of this, this is part of what I teach here. So if you're interested in this type of thing, consider signing up for the newsletter. But here, CTNT. So that green line right there, that's the 9-day. And when you hear me talk about confirmation, I want the price to close above the 9-day. And when it closes below the 9-day, I want to get out. Now, this candle right here, that's an 8 o'clock candle, 8:10 candle, it's always crazy. It's always nuts. There's always an 8 o'clock candle that's crazy. So, you know, where are we right now? This is a 5-minute. So we just opened up. It's now 9:34. Your range right now, you opened at 782 and you're currently at 722. So you're down 5%. I would expect this one to continue to be crazy. Look at that MACD on the 5-minute. You could trade this one on the MACD. See how it went from 257 up to 641 and then pulled back. That was a 5-minute candle where you lost confirmation right there at about 499 and you could have sold out. And it just went straight. Take your profit and then get back in when you regain confirmation at 639. And you went all the way up to 907. And then you lost confirmation here. You could have sold at 7. Okay? That's how you use confirmation. If you layer in the strategies of the MACD and the RSI, you can set up Trendspider to alert you when something like this happens on a 5-minute if you're watching that stock. Again, that's what Trendspider brings you. It brings you the opportunity to take a look at this stuff. But if you can't afford Trendspider, any free charting program, anything, will be able to do a 9-day EMA. Just set that up. Try trading on it. Do some type of, you know, paper trading where you don't spend money on it and you just test it out and you buy and sell. Do something like that or set a spreadsheet up where you would have bought and sold and get used to trading on these technicals, whether it's 5 minutes, whether it's 4 hour, whether it's weekly, whatever you do, understand charts. It was the biggest step up that I took was when I understood technical trading and when I understood, hey, The 9-day moves at a certain period. The 21-day moves at another period. The 50 and the 200 move at another period. Oh, this is how it interacts with the MACD. Oh, the RSI. Well, what does that mean? Oh, Bollinger Bands actually help you? Yes. Yes. All of that stuff that I just went over real quick. You know, oh, volume has a profile? Yep. Yep, absolutely. So Trendspider is one of those things that has all of these things built in, and you can set up alerts on it. It's really one of those. And again, you have 15 hours to sign up. But this type of news, when it comes out at 2:40 a.m. and you see it start to move at 4 a.m., you can take it. This is why I lose money doing the podcast, is because I do my research and stuff like that, and I don't trade. When I was trading, there was a lot of opportunity like that. Okay. Credo Technologies, surges. We talked about this one on earnings, CRDO. We can take a look at this one, CRDO. We can look at this one prior to, in the pre-market. Let's take a look at this one on a five-minute chart. See how it pumped up there after its earnings right there? It hasn't shown much. I wouldn't be getting into this one right now. I would say, you know, in my mind, it's not worth the risk, because I think you might be pulling back towards this gap fill today. But if you start to see a big climb up on a 5-minute or 1-minute, start to get in. It doesn't make sense to go all out and say, hey, I'm going to make 10% on this stock in a day trading like that. It makes more sense to just build your 1, 2, 3, 4% and trade on those moving averages. And there are certain patterns that you could pick up. There are certain things. That's what Warrior Trading on YouTube teaches. He teaches all of the momentum stuff, and that's what you're trading on. You're not trading on fundamentals, because if you're trading a stock that's on fundamentals, you're doing it more than a five-minute chart. So understand that. But again, Credo Technologies, Cheetah, those are just things. Now, I did go over on the YouTube Live about buying the Alpha Picks portfolio, and we did get one yesterday. It is what it is, so if you want to look at that one, you can. Let's talk about scans, because we got some 4-hour scans, cross-ups. Google is an interesting one. This one had a buy in the algorithm yesterday at 172. Again, I said, I'm going to sell a lot of Google, and it's going to be between this 171 and 193 area. So I'll be looking the next time that the algorithm actually gets me out. I didn't want to sell on the weakness down here. I want to sell on strength. Roblox. We talked about this one. This one being under 40 play, it's now kind of hanging out at 50. And it got an algorithm buy here at 52. You had this nice 20% gain. And you can see the algorithm doesn't time the top. It doesn't time the bottom. Just gets in at certain times and gets out at others. But it gets you in here at 52. I don't know that I'd necessarily buy that one, because, you know, again, their earnings were great. And I do think that you provided. See how it pulled back here? See this candle right here? This, after they announced earnings, the period, it opened up at 51.12 and it closed at 51.55. It was on, this is a 4-hour candle, so it's only 0.84 during that percent. But the gap up here presented an opportunity. Look at how well that gap provided you support right there. Right at about 46 to say, 46 to 48. It pushed you right up. I mean, it didn't come back down and fill that gap. So it's bouncing off. I think that means that we're going for a higher high. And you're going back there. Now, look at this weekly chart. If you look at this, I'm going to remove this. This goes back to its IPO, which was 2021, where it went all the way up to $140. Okay? Went all the way up to $140. You're trading at 52. Does it make sense to buy this one? The valuation is nuts. This one is not making money. The valuation is absolutely crazy on this. If you look at Wall Street, the average price target, 55. You're trading at 52 right now. That's a nice 6% upside. Will you get there? Probably. But the valuation is crazy. You're not making money, so you don't have a PE. Your growth is fantastic at 27%. When the sector's growing at 1%, your levered free cash flow, you're growing at 381%. When they start turning a profit, expect this company to actually explode back towards that $200 level. So, and I have no doubt in my mind that this company will at some point in time return a profit. It is the metaverse. It is the only place in the metaverse where creators can actually make money. And so, you know, Meta, even though they're named Meta, they ain't doing anything in that space anymore. They're all in on AI. So you got that one. You got Synopsys, you got Comcast. One that's interesting with an entry in the four-hour algorithm, and I do think the financials do really well under the new administration, is Citibank. This one got you in at 69, yeah, and it's been up since. This is a secondary entry, so at 71, 72 in the algorithm. Now, if I had an alert on this one, it would show an alert to buy to add to this position. This one, my favorite bank analyst is Mike Mayo from Bank of America. This is his top pick for 2025, and it just got an entry in the algorithm. Now, you can see this was his top pick in 2024 as well. Look at where it opened up 2024. It opened up at 51, and you're trading at 72. That's a pretty good stock to get into for the year, okay? Yes, you had some fluctuations in this up and down. And I think that 69 level is going to provide you support. Why? Look at how it was resistance right here. Now, if we pull back to that 69 level, that's where I would rather buy it. But at 72, again, if your time frame is 2025, what do you care between 69 and 72? Start adding to it today. You know, dollar cost average your way in. So, but I thought that was interesting as well. We got some leveraged ETFs, QQQU, MAGS, USD, MAGX. All of them got cross-ups and their entries into the algorithm. So if you want the algorithm, again, just sign up, take advantage of the Trendspider deal. It is going on. I think the best deal that you could get that is just plug and play. You don't have to even learn anything. It's just, you know, it gives you information that's ad-free. And you can go and you can look at top stocks. Just go and look at top stocks. This one right here, PSIX, has been the top stocks for quite a while. Look at that one. Year-to-date, you're up 1,451%. We talked about this one all the time. This is trading at all-time highs at 31. The all-time high was 35. So, and if you go and look at other top stocks, you know, Kingstone companies, I know none of these, but look at this one. You know, year-to-date, this one's up 696%. Again, it's top stocks. These things just show up at certain times in here, and you can go and research them. Carnival Cruise Line, this is an alpha pick. This one, year-to-date, it's up 42%. And when did it get to a strong buy? You can go and look. It just got back to a strong buy in 12.2 at $25. You're trading at 26. So again, that's what seeking alpha premium gets you. We talked about alpha picks already. If you have any questions, just go over to Linktree. We got a private Facebook group that you can join. You can follow me on X, Twitter, whatever you want. My email address is also up here. So make sure you sign up for the newsletter. It's free. And join Webull. Webull, you know, yesterday I was trading on you know, I was sitting at a supercharger, and I decided to trade using Webull's app. I turned $1,000 into $10,000 on Webull. I think I'm at 10,500 something. I did get out of my MicroStrategy in there. It is heavily in NVIDIA, Apple, and iBit. Those are the things. But when you sign up through my link, you get free stocks. So sign up for Webull. Okay. I will talk to you guys tomorrow. See you, bye. Every morning I wake up to the sound of the trading bell. My heart starts to pound. Daily stock pick trading podcast in my ears. Guiding me through my hopes and fears. Tune in daily, don't miss a single show. Sign up for the newsletter, let us help you grow. Taking risks, making moves, seeking success. Together we'll conquer, no room for any less. Every morning I wake up to the sound. The trading bell, my heart starts to pound. Daily stock pick trading podcast in my ears, guiding me through my hopes and fears. Tune in daily, don't miss a single show. Sign up for the newsletter, let us help you grow. Taking risks, making moves, seeking success. Together we'll conquer, no room for any less. Listen now.